this morning. The other thing to know too, the speaker view, if you put the speaker view on, it will probably bring the biggest picture of up onto the screen of the person speaking. So I will mute myself now, and I'm going to turn it over to Tanny Barnes to open us up with a couple of gospel tunes this morning to get our get us up and going. So Danny, take us away if you will.
Okay. Sing its words, it sounds like music in my ear, the sweetest name on earth. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, because he first loved me. It tells me of a Savior's love who died to set me free. It tells me of his precious blood, the sinner's perfect plea. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, because he first loved me. Tells me of love and heart can feel my deepest woe, who searches it, ever bears the part that none can bear below. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, because he first loved me. Okay, then I like this one, 172, I like this one here. This one goes, there is a fountain. There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's vein. And sinners plunged beneath the flood lose all their guilty stain. Lose all their guilty stain. Lose all their guilty stain. And sinners plunged beneath the flood lose all their guilty stains. Dear dying Lamb, thy precious blood shall never lose its power, till all the ransomed church of God be saved to sin no more. May he save to sin no more. Be saved to sin no more. Till all the ransomed church of God be saved to sin no more.
Amazing. I could watch that all morning. That was fantastic. You all will have Danny Barnes. He's going to hang around and be, we'll have, I have about a 20-minute, basically, this is our liturgy that we came up this week. So we've got about a 23 or 24-minute worship service that I've compiled with a lot of people. Deborah, thank you for sending in the prayers. And Stefan, thank you for your reading of the gospel. And then Karen, thank you for giving us another reading. So thank you all for those who continue to just keep sending in and helping this service happen. It's so great that we find new ways in this new time to make this thing happen. So I am going to share my screen and get this service going. So here we go. View. I think I forgot to share my screen. Now it's working.
good morning and welcome to the sixth Sunday of Easter. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Ring, 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 ring. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer.
Be with you. O God, who has prepared for those who love thee such good things as man passes understanding, pour into our hearts such love toward thee, that we, loving thee in all things and above all things, may obtain thy promises, which exceed all that we can desire. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul stood in front of the Areopagus and said, Athenians, I see how extremely religious you are in every way. For as I went through the city and looked carefully at the objects of your worship, I found among them an altar with the inscription, To an unknown God. What therefore you worship as unknown, this I proclaim to you. The God who made the world and everything in it, he who is Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in shrines made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands, as though he needed anything, since he himself gives to all mortals life and breath and all things. From one ancestor, he made all nations to inhabit the whole earth, and he allotted the times of their existence and the boundaries of the places where they would live, so that they would search for God and perhaps grope for him and find him, though indeed he is not far from each one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being, as even some of your own poets have said, for we too are his offspring. Since we are God's offspring, we ought not to think that the deity is like gold or silver or stone, an image formed by the art and imagination of mortals. While God has overlooked the times of human ignorance, now he commands all people everywhere to repent, because he has fixed a day on which he will have the world judged in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed, and of this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead. The word of the Lord.
Glory, hallelujah. reading from the Gospel of John. Jesus said, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you will also live. On that day, you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them." The word of the Lord.
Well, welcome. Good morning to Easter 6. I'm in my shed again, doing a sermon. I had other plans. My software didn't work out quite the way I wanted it to. So I'm punting at the last minute, coming up with a different message. Not different message, but just a different way to say it. So we get a wonderful piece of scripture this morning about keeping God's commandments and God sending us an advocate to do that. And we get advocates in all sorts of different ways, I think, to keep those commandments. And sometimes it's the strangers that we meet along the way, and sometimes it's the banjo musicians that you admire. And I had a real advocate experience this week with Danny Barnes, one of my definite banjo heroes, I guess you could say. It was so great to have a moment with him and talk about music and all the ways it inspires us to see who we are. Before we go down that road, just commandments are on the table today, and we read them a lot in Lent. We don't read them a lot now, so I'm wondering how many of you can remember commandments just off the top of your head. There's the first one. I know I ask the kids a lot, what are the two greatest things? To love God with all your heart, mind, and soul, and to love your neighbor as yourself. We get those from Jesus, but the ones we get from the Old Testament, when Moses came down the mountain, we get, you know, don't make any graven image, don't put anything before God, don't take the name of the Lord your God in vain, keep the Sabbath day holy. I don't know about you, but Sabbath is such a talked about commandment in the Bible, and it's so important in these times. I think it really helps set a rhythm of life. Today is Sunday, if you didn't know that. Honor thy mother and father. Don't murder. Don't commit adultery. Don't steal. Don't bear false witness against your neighbor. And do not covet what your neighbor has. So those are the Ten Commandments that we generally read throughout out the season of Lent. And those are really good. I mean, they help us know how to live in the world with one another. It helps us keep in right relationship with God. But just memorizing those commandments doesn't really necessarily bring us to a place of living into those commandments. Living into I think the message we get from Jesus today is about action and holding close to those commandments that God gives us. And I think one of the fun advocates we all have is music. Music, I think, helps remind us and reiterates and puts it on a local context, if you will, that stretches back to the ancient story of Scripture, the story of salvation. And on a banjo, there's one of my favorite storytelling devices. There's a thing called a bridge right here. And this bridge is the thing that generates sound. It pushes those strings up high enough, and that sound goes through that bridge and kind of bounces through the back of the banjo, and that banjo resonates out through this resonator. It's this really beautiful, beautiful, beautiful resonator. So I think as Christians, we sit at the bridge. We sit at the story of this ancient, beautiful story of salvation, living in this modern context of how do we tell the good news, the gospel news, to the world. That's what we have this week. We have gospel music at Danny Barnes. Helen, the reminder of the good news that comes out. Gospel music is funny. I was so excited to talk with Danny. I was like, what is gospel music? And then Danny stops. Well, I guess it's about Jesus. And I'm 100% correct on that one, Danny. Thank you for that reminder. It's not a genre as much of it is about storytelling. And it can be about the ways of sin and seeing the light and turning. It can be keeping on the sunny side. It can be keeping that circle unbroken, holding fast to that faith. There's so many beautiful expressions of gospel music. The banjo just happens to be one that I love. It was great to interview Danny and talk more. I wish I could share more of that video with you all. I hope that this resonates with you. I hope that you know that you all are, in my mind, little banjos out there in the world in certain ways, and we resonate that salvation story, that good news story out to the world, not only by the words we memorize, but more importantly about the good work we do with our hands and our feet and our mouth and the encouragement in these times. So, amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. For the Holy Church of God, that it may be filled with truth and love and be found without fault at the day of your coming, we pray to you, O Lord. For Michael, our presiding bishop, for Andy, Jeff, Kay, and Hector, our own bishops, for our priest, for our seminarians, for all bishops and other ministers, and for all the holy people of God, we pray to you, O Lord. For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our divisions may cease, that all may be one as you and the Father are one, we pray to you, O Lord. For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray to you, O Lord. For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among nations and peoples, we pray to you, O Lord. For those in positions of public trust, especially Donald, our president, Greg, our governor, and Steve, our mayor, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person, we pray to you, O Lord. For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected, we pray to you, O Lord. For this congregation, that we may be delivered from hardness of heart and show forth your glory in all that we do, we pray to you, O Lord. For all who have commended themselves to our prayers, especially Jackie, Dudley, Lisa, Mason, Catherine, Matt, Tammy, Kennedy, Margaret, Allison, Raymond, Sydney, Hazel, Thomas, Miha, Dan, Jerry, David, Andrea, Bernie, Nancy, for our families, friends, and neighbors, that being freed from anxiety, they may live in joy, peace, and health. We pray to you, O Lord. For all who have died in the communion of your church, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. We pray to you, O Lord. Rejoicing in the fellowship of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God.
Amen. Thank you again to all those who helped make that service happen this week. It's always a treat and pleasure to get to hear your voices and see some of you. All right. Well, continuing with our offertory, we got a little mini concert coming all the way from the Pacific Northwest with Danny Barnes. So, Danny, you are unmuted and ready to go. So whenever you're ready.
Okay.
Thanks again for being here with us.
Oh, I appreciate your time. Thank you for letting me be here. I want to play this tune farther along. Tempted and tried, we're oft made to wonder why it should be thus all the day long, when there are others living about us, never molested, though in the wrong. Farther along, we'll know all about it. Farther along, we'll understand why. Cheer up, my brother, live in the sunshine. We'll understand it all by and by. Faithful till death, said our loving master, a few more days to labor and wait. Toils of the road will then seem as nothing when we slip through the beautiful gate. Farther along, we'll know all about it. Farther along, we'll up my brother, live in a sunshine. We'll understand it all by and by.
Two more? Are you sure? Okay. This is one I like to play. Most of the songs from this world that I play in a lot of times, it seems like a lot of these are actually from the church I grew up in, were more funeral songs. So, but this one here is a Carter family tune that I think is A.P. Carter.
There's a dark and a troubled side of life. There's a bright and a sunny side too. Though we meet with the darkness and strife, the sunny side we also may view. Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day, it will brighten all the way, if we'll keep on the sunny side of life. Well, the storm and its fury broke today, crushing moments we cherish so dear. Clouds and storm will in time pass away, the sun again will shine bright and clear. Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day, it will brighten all the way, if we'll keep on the sunny side of life. Let the banjo play. Let us greet with a song of hope each day, whether moments be cloudy or fair. Let us trust in the Savior always, to keep us ever one in His care. Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day, it will brighten all the way, if we'll keep on the sunny side of life. If we'll keep on the sunny side of life.
Amazing. Thank you so much. Give us another one.
One more?
Okay. Oh, yeah, please do.
This is 347 in my book. There's that Standing on the Promises. Do y'all sing that song?
Now, Danny, you say your book, is that your hymnal from when you grew up as a kid? Or?
Well, I have the one from the church where my grandma and granddad helped build the Church of Christ in Belton, Texas, and I have that hymnal. It's over there. This is a different one. This is another Church of Christ that they got new hymnals and they gave all these away. It has a whole bunch of the songs. So between the two, I kind of got all the songs from when I grew up covered pretty good. Yeah. But this is this one here. It's the
songs of the church.
It's in shape notes, you know, like I grew up singing shape notes, all a cappella. Like without music, we sang a cappella shape notes. You ever seen that before?
No. That's
it's
great.
Like each do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do has a particular shape, like do is a triangle and sol is a circle and so forth. But you can change the key without having to rewrite the music because it's in shape notes, you know. Like if you didn't have enough basses and you had to pitch it up a little bit or something, yeah. You can pitch this music up or down.
That's amazing.
Anyway, I like that one, Standing on the Promises. Promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest, I will shout and sing. Standing in the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God my Savior. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God. Promises that cannot fail, when the howling storms of doubt and fear assail, by the living word of God I shall prevail. Standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God my Savior. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God. On the promises I cannot fail, listen every moment to the Spirit's call, resting in my Savior as my all in all. I'm standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God my Savior. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God.
Standing on the promise. Oh, Danny, thank you so much. It was so fun this week to get to talk to you. I wish I could have pulled in more of that conversation. It was amazing. The music you create and continue to create is inspiring and amazing. The depth of your music is unbelievable, to pull out the old hymnal and bring us closer to that. That sacred story this morning is just a true treat. I really, really, really appreciate it. So it's hard to even, I could do this all day and watch you play. You're so good. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks for letting me play.
Yeah. Well, next week we're going to have, you know what? We're going to have camp music next week for all those people who loved summer camps as kids. I got some camp musician friends of mine throughout the Diocese of Texas and West Texas, and we're going to be playing some of those camp greats bringing you music in the best way we can next week. Great things continue to happen up here. The parish hall keeps cranking out food for people under the bridge and in the homeless encampments around town. We're getting a lot of stuff grown in the garden, putting those vegetables out there, as well as getting lots of food donations that would oftentimes just go to the trash, are coming into our parish hall, and we're preparing amazing meals and getting them out there. So keep praying for that the amazing work that's coming out of there. That's all I have this week. It's been a wild one. So what I'll do, here's how we end this service, is I unmute everyone, and we end with our wild and crazy latent driven Lord's Prayer, where we all say it together and it all comes out all wild, but it's just a beautiful thing. So I'm going to unmute everybody, and we'll do the Lord's Prayer, and we'll end with the peace. Lots of love to you all as you go out into this world. Danny, thank you again for all the amazing music, and we'll keep on going out there and doing the Lord's work as we can. So here I go. I'm unmuting you all. All participants unmuted, my computer said. And praying the words that Jesus taught us, Father.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us
this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those
who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Well, brothers and sisters in Christ, peace of the Lord be always with you.
Also with you.
Our weekly Bible study on Wednesday morning, and we'll be back here tuned in next 10:30 on Sunday. So cheers to you all. Blessings.
Thanks, Billy.
Peace out.
Thanks, Billy. Thanks, Danny. Love y'all.
Bye.
Great week.
That's love.
Bye, Pam.
I'll sing it. That.
Love you.
Bye.
Love everybody.
Bye, love you.
Bye.
Bye. Good to see everybody.
Right here. Say bye-bye.
Bye.
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 I'm still watching it.
Bye-bye,
Jonah. Jonah.
Yes.
Bye.
Good to see you, Mike and Granville.
Someone said, bye-bye, Jonah.
What a treat. All right. If anyone needs to get in touch with me, email will be the thing for the rest of the day. My phone will be back online, hopefully this evening.
Do you all have copies of Forward Day by Day?
I'm looking. They are not here. So I'm.
They haven't come? Okay.
I don't know if.
We can get it online.
Yeah, I know. Not the same. And if they do come, I will send them out. But I
can't. Okay.
And I think Forward Movement didn't send them out, so.
Oh, okay.
So, but if they do come, I'll be in touch.
Okay.
All right. All Wednesday. Bye.
Bye. Bye.